Life comes with its hurdles and obstacles, but there are ways in which we can better cope with pressure and mitigate its impact on our body and health. I'm your host, Casper, he, him, his pronouns, and during this quick set, we will take a look at times when you may have felt under pressure and how this may have affected you. We are also going to give you some helpful tips on how to stay real while dealing with pressure. Take a moment and think about a time in your life when you felt under a lot of pressure. I can imagine that a lot of us think about something school and work related, right? It could be a time you had to meet a deadline, prepare for an exam, compete in a competitive environment. It could have even been a time when you felt overwhelmed, but you were still expected to perform at your best. We all have been there in one way or another and have felt the pressure. Whilst experiencing pressure is a part of our lives, it is important that we keep an eye on how it affects our physical and mental health. Can you think of a time when your body has given you signs that the pressure was becoming too much? How did you feel? And also, what did you feel? Headaches, stomach pains, feeling tired or experiencing difficulties falling asleep? Did you feel irritable or sad? These are only some of the symptoms that can be related to experiencing pressure and stress. It is important that you do not ignore these symptoms, as there are ways of how you can cope better with pressure and ease the toll it's taking on your body and mind. Before we give you some tips on how to stay real whilst dealing with pressure, we are going to see what one of our artists has to say about this topic. And who better to talk about his experiences of keeping focused whilst under pressure than Ghetts. Hi Ghetts, thank you so much for joining me today. Do you mind sharing a time in your career when you really felt the pressure build up?
Every day.
Every day, I hear that.
Every day the pressure is building. You know, there's different types of pressure, but it's kind of, I guess how I deal with it. I really enjoy what I do. For me, I'd say just weigh out the pros and cons, really, you know. There's going to be pressure in anything you do. How I kind of weigh it up is more, it's like, it's a dream job for me. I dreamt of doing this. I could be in a different situation and still having different, the pressure would still be there, but I wouldn't be in my dream job, you know? So I just take it, I look at it like that and just understand it's a blessing to be in this position, dealing with pressure, than being in a position that I don't want to be in, dealing with pressure somewhere else, you know? So I just kind of look at it like that.
Thank you so much for inspiring words, Ghetts. Now, youth campaigner, well-being and awareness specialist, Mary Daniels, will be giving you some advice on how to better cope with pressure.
Hi, my name is Mary Daniels. I'm a coach consultant. So one top tip for any of you out there that are really dealing with a lot of pressure, I'm gonna go to the word presence. And I would say really focus on just being present to what is happening in the moment, without worrying about what's happening next or how you're going to, you know, control the outcome or what might happen in the future. Just really come back to the moment, take a breath and just accept things happen in seasons. So, you know, the pressure won't be there all the time. So if you just stay present and respond to what's happening in the moment, without sort of getting into your head too much, then that can help you just chunk things down and be able to just take one step at a time through whatever's going on and knowing it will pass, it always passes. Yeah, I think sort of words of wisdom for any young person out there who's really in need now. One thing I learned is just, first of all, ask for help. Really, don't worry, people won't judge you. There is help out there. So if you're really in need and really struggling, reach out for help, whether it is with somebody that you know that you, and you trust that you can talk to, that will really listen to you, not laugh it off, but really listen to you, or somebody in a position of responsibility that you know can help you get the help that you need. Or if you want to do it anonymously, there are sort of numbers that you can call and places you can go to. But if you're really, really struggling, I would say definitely reach out for help.
Ghetts and Mary gave you some amazing insights into how to cope with pressure and stay real. I hope this helps y'all when moving forward during this challenging time. I will leave y'all with this inspirational quote by Ed Jacoby. Pressure comes from within. and so must be mastered from within.